I have such a complicated past with Final Fantasy. And mainly because, like, I told you how I even started playing it, right?
Yeah, some friends or whatever.
Julie?
Yeah, my ex.
Bruno Fernandes.
Like, years ago.
Another useful cross.
Until Jared, it was the first and only relationship I was in. But, you know, we started playing because he was a Final Fantasy fanatic fan, whatever. But, ever since then, it just, like, stuck. And just hadn't, I don't know, like, even with other shit. You know what? I met people. I met, Hubie and Haseya way back when. And then, like in 2017, 20, actually 20, 2019, I think, I met, my friends in Baltimore. Well, one, they were both in Baltimore at the time. Now one's in Texas. Making for a comfortable finish. It's a really great goal. So continuing with the match, and that goal for the Foxes means they can now entertain thoughts of perhaps pulling. That game is part of the reason. Huey, that game is part of the reason why I got on a plane for the first time.
Why you what for the first time?
Why I got on a plane for the first time. Because I went to go see my friend Kyle in Texas. I'd never flown before that. And you're like, hey, I'm having a birthday party. I'd love it if you could come. Mind you, we were just in a rage group. I mean, we bonded really closely, but... I don't know. I've never been out that far on my own. But...
All my bags are packed. I'm ready to go.
Hey man, I'm just waiting for a 3-day weekend. I'll be down there in Florida. What a waste that is. The airport right here. It goes straight from here to there.
I hate to wake you up. Zola. Here's Vinicius Jr.
And very deftly cut out. Just 15 minutes remaining. Really important piece of last ditch defending. Adenia.
And on to Pele. Getting in there to intercept. Motherfuck! Thank you. She has teammates around her. Holy shit. Annoying ass mother.
Over the touchline for a throw in.
Oh man, this thing dirty. Oh my god. Did not let this happen again. Futre. Now with Rolfe.
How simple for the keeper. Atenea.
Down by a goal. This could be their final opportunity to snatch something. Putre. This could be it. And it is. He's done it. Surely a case of game over.
Well, here's the replay. And just look at that power. That's almost unstoppable. That's a great strike.
Well, it comes down to the final 5 minutes.
Good work from the Nutters to win the ball back. Dicing with a bit of danger here.
Yo, but oh my LA god.
Could pull one back here. Oh, not to be. Stopping a certain goal. One minute of stoppage time has been added on. And a throw in it's going to be.
That was just silly, man.
And there it is, the final whistle, and the fans will be leaving.
I do a beautiful lob pass to this guy. Well, Derek, and the guy's like a master dribbler. Like, he receives the ball however the fuck you get it to him. And because I pressed L1, the fucking ball hit him on his back. Like, what?
Oh.
It bounced right off his back, man. That's a good gummy.
I'm definitely gonna need to smoke because today has been a day. I'll have to go into detail another time, but you know, I have to say, Felix, the therapy is working. Which is crazy, because, like, I have to believe, like, I have to, like, tell myself sometimes that, like, I'm not faking it. Like, I actually do have the, you know, like, emotional strength to deal with things, and, you know, like, I'm not just faking being calm or, you know, or rather, it's the acknowledgement that I am I am reacting. Like, I'm doing it, but internally. I'm just not externalizing the process.
I think what you're saying is that you have developed a higher level of self-control of your emotions.
Yeah, yeah.
I think that's wonderful.
It is. It is. It's so strange because it gives me such feelings of dissonance of, you know, like I was just saying, like, I'll be more upset later, or, you know, like, I just don't feel it right now, or, you know, that kind of line of thinking. But then, you know, just not giving that emotional energy to, you know, like, rile up or, and again, you know, still being an emotional creature and, like, having emotions, but just not lashing out because of it, like, just still being in control.
So who was that message for earlier? Give it to me straight.
Oh, I just saw a funny Spanish meme from my guild. So I posted it. Mm. I did it because I love that episode of South Park, and it's hilarious. And I could actually, like, I could understand what was written.
I thought you were doing some passive aggressive.
No. I think that episode is one of the best episodes of South Park, to be honest with you. Like, it honestly is, because the way that, like, Cartman just loses it. Because it's the perfect way. Like, that is the exact way to deal with a bully. But then Cartman did what we all knew he would, which is just, you know, be the evil little Satan spawn and think of a way to still manipulate. But it was very hilarious.
Hold on. Let me call Sammy here to play. Hold on.
Mm-hmm.
shining like I'm diamonds or on gloss. What's the gloss on the blocks? Wanna know who has got the man? I maneuver to the top. I'm on the lot, that's why I'm on the top. Ever since the young, I had the hunger, so I never stop. Clever clocks always put the pressure on. Elevate the
boy. You were saying, you know, just the tools and the practices are working. Like, it's not, you know, it's not all hocus pocus. It's not, you know, in my mind, like, I'm stronger.
Yeah.
Speaking of stronger, I bought some gold a little bit earlier from one of my guildmates in Lost Ark. And in that same line of what we were talking about the other day with, you know, just the power of money. I am, and I hate that, I guess that it is this way, but I'm understanding the, you know, the triangle, time, money, speed. And when it comes down to certain games, you really can fast track your enjoyment with just a couple dollars. Like, for better or worse, it is what it is. And as a working adult, I can understand why some people value their time as much as they do. Because I'll tell you what, like, if I was, you know, and I see it all the time, like, on Reddit, of, you know, like, dads talking about how, you know, they have to balance out, you know, time. And you do it too. But, like, being able, or not having to sacrifice, you know, something that I do enjoy, because I do enjoy the combat. Like, they nailed it. They got the combat down. Classes down. But being able to still enjoy it now, you know, I paid like $30 or whatever to get some gold. And when I sent it to him on PayPal, I saw, like, it was converted into pesos. And I'm like, holy shit, this is like however many hundred it was. He's like, oh yeah. Like, that's why he farms gold. Because he, and so, like, by deciding to still have fun, you know, like, just like how the economy works, money makes money. Mm-hmm. So, you know, like, I'm not even gonna lie, like, I do feel a little good by, like, I don't know what he's gonna use it for, but I know that I feel better giving it to a friend as opposed to, you know, some rando or whatever. But also, I still get to have fun and, you know, what I like. And what did it cost me? Not much. So I guess it's a lesson in, like, learning how to enjoy myself. Now, of course, you know, not just spending on shit hog wild with, you know, reckless hedonism. But not making joy so arduous by limiting myself on how I can have it. Like, there's no the set or defined way, you know, that I have to play the game, enjoy the game. I can do it how I want.
Yeah, it's like the bots in 14.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly like that. Like, no, I'm sorry. I'm not going to spend, you know, 6 hours over the course of 3 days farming one stack of, you know, like, no. And Final Fantasy has even less of a reason to do it because they already have their money. They're not doing microtransactions like anything else. So it's wholly egregious there.
Damn, you know what? You're absolutely freaking right, bro.
That's part of the reason why, like, that's part of the reason why I switched from PlayStation to PC, because I'm like, it's a scam. It is a fucking racket. Felix, you've seen the amount of just the sheer difference that you can do, the access that you have, whether you do it or not, the opportunity pales in comparison. But that's what, again, that's what makes it so unforgivable in Final Fantasy VI, is the fact that you guys, you're charging top dollar. You're charging for the subscription. You're charging for the game, which you recently just stopped doing that. You're charging for, you know, the mounts, the dances, the emotes. They're all at least $5 to $7. You're charging for skips. You know, you gotta pay per platform. You gotta have a license per platform. And you still want time on top of that? Come on, y'all.
Have you ever posted that on Reddit? Like on a 14 forum?
No, because there's too many people that are like Final Fantasy brainwashed that would just jump to defend literally anything and won't hear reason. But anyone that plays on PC, there are very few people that have anything of worth in that game, like anything in game, whether it be cosmetic or not, of worth, that did it number one on console, and number two, through sheer manpower alone. And the worst thing is, like, when you're like, in order to make money, like crafting, you gotta gather. Because in order to craft the shit, you need the materials to do so. Mm-hmm. And some of the materials only show up at certain times. Like, it's bad enough that you gotta go out, you gotta spend time fucking gathering it, but now I have to plan my time to spend? Come on, y'all. Come on. Stop it.
And stick to a schedule that you have to find out what that schedule is, because the specific ingredients drop at those time intervals.
You know, then you got to play a little mini game in order to get the, you know, the high quality drop. Like, y'all.
Yeah, man. You know what? Even on a bot, I don't miss that.
Right.
That's how tedious. Like, because I was there establishing the bot right before I go to sleep. Like, worrying about this shit more than brushing my teeth, you know, like.
Yeah, like, because you have to put in, like, you have to do a regimen. And not only that, but, like, the time gating, like, you know, like, in order for, it takes 18 hours. It's been taking 18 hours for your retainer to do a long mission since the game fucking started, Felix. Expeditions, 18 hours. Airships, 18 hours. And then you have, on top of that, you have materials that you can only get through expeditions that you need a house in order to do. And not just any house, but you need a guild house.
Oh, man. I may never go to 14 again.
But, like, that's like, nah, man, like, my time is valuable. Time is money. Time is money. And they know that. But my thing is, like, how am I supposed to be able to keep paying my subscription if, like, come on. Like, make my time here meaningful. Make it meaningful. I used to talk shit about people on PC, too, till I played on it.
This guy just that I'm playing right now, his name is Shrimp Daddy.
That's one thing I will say from I learned playing with Dan is I learned how to win.
Yeah, man. I mean, yeah, this is. It's just get me to the good shit.
Yeah, like there's just no excuse. Like it's tedious. It's tedious. The amount it takes as much time to level up a gathering class as it does a battle class. And I get it. Like there has to be like you know something to work towards, all that other stuff, blah blah blah. But it's not like they just have like six different professions. Like the that shit is a whole. That's a game in and of itself. The crafting and gathering and farming and all like that. That is its own end game. Mm-hmm. They even have their own. You got them. The special weapons, mm-hmm. relic weapons.
What are y'all talking about now?
Oh, uh-oh.
Out of them shits.
Final Fantasy is really, really doing it. They're so good.
Oh, okay.
He looks. Say something. He's gonna beat us.
Felix is alright. It's you that always has a problem.
Oh jeez.
Just think that you're in another
what,
place.
What are you complaining about now, Ash?
Just think you're in another place.
I was just saying that Final Fantasy 14 could do better to respect people's time.
What do you mean?
We're just talking about the whole craft and gathering loot and the sheer amount of like determination it takes to like so okay so say you want to be a crafter and gatherer right so then that means or say you want to buy a home in order to do that you have to generate income easiest way to generate income in that game if you're not selling ultimate run is by crafting or gathering. And in order to craft and gather, you have to have the, not only the materials, but also, depending on what it is that you're making, the area to do so. So I was talking to Felix and telling him how, like, for instance, you have some materials that you can only get through expeditions, but expeditions are locked behind guilds. Like you cannot have like a workstation or whatever outside of a guild home. So you have to do that. You have to have you know the materials to do so. And all of this is happening. Like they're keeping you in the game. They're sinking your time. But there's no reason for them to sink your time because they're not profiting off of like microtransactions like another game or whatever. They're subscription based. And not only are they subscription based, everything in this game is an upfront cost save for the mod station items. You gotta buy the subscription, you have to buy the license per platform. And before you even actually I had to buy the actual game, like you had to get the base game and then the expansions before, you know, they just included it. Now you just get the subscription or whatever. Actually, no, I still think you still have to like them. But long story short, all of these tactics to, you know, sink time, but there's no reason for them to do so. So why are they doing it? And on top of that, like some of the systems being gated and kept behind what could be pretty difficult and obscure systems to break into, i.e. the expeditions and having a, you know, being able to get the materials that come from them to craft certain things. Because again, they're only for guild homes and only the guild master or whoever they, you know, designate can operate it. So even if you were to join a guild, if your guild master isn't actually checking the shit, it's all for nothing anyway. But you could just have your own guild. Well, that's what we were talking about in the first place. And in order to do that, you would have to not only start a guild, but then actually buy a housing plot to be able to do that. Which is not that easy. Or at least it wasn't. Can't speak for it now because I don't know the housing market. And that was my investigative journalism.
Can't you just join a guild too and do that?
You could, but that's what I'm saying. Like, if you could join the guild, but if the guild master or their designees aren't checking the ship, sending it out, you know, like,
us,
you still have to do it vicariously. So basically, like, you're paying, but you can't access all the stuff. And it's not like you just have to put in the work. It takes an exorbitant amount of work to be able to have the chance to do it.
Yeah. You got to put all that on Reddit, man. Or maybe I'll just record this conversation the past half hour.
But don't you niggas, even, like, don't you niggas be cheating? Can I have your computer do it for you?
See? I told you.
Takes too long, man.
Takes too long, but you're not doing anything.
Right. But the fact that it takes too long...
But that's what I'm saying. Like, it takes such a long amount of time that, okay, so say, you know, you have, like, 3 hours a day to play. And you want to, you know, you're trying to gather to craft and make money. But it takes a long amount of time to gather manually because you can only do one node at a time, and then you have to do it. Like, you have to route your, you know, or if you're smart, you plan your route of where you're going, what you're going to be getting, all that other stuff, the times they appear. All of that. Just to have the chance to, you know, get into the actual in-game crafting and whatnot. To sell the stuff that really makes money.
I just want to say I beat Shrimp Daddy.
Good job, dude. That was all.
Why did you even think about this?
Because I was telling Felix that I bought gold from a guild member on Lost Ark, and I'm having so much fun with it now.
Oh, because you did what Felix did.
Of course.
Mm-hmm. And I learned that, like, $30 US is about, like, $6.50 Mexican.
Six, what do you mean 650? Like 650?
Yes, 650 pesos. Wild, right? I sent the money to my guild member, and I was, it showed me the conversion. I'm like, holy shit! Like, it's, this is 650. He's like, oh yeah.
Holy shit, that's a legit pass. Oh my god.
Let me go rinse these parts off. Yeah.
Kind of bullshit, but hey, I will take it.